excited?
Yes.
That's terrific. And we're going to begin as we always begin. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
My friends, to prepare ourselves to celebrate this first Holy Communion Mass, we call to mind that God knows each one of us by name. And God loves us beyond imagining.
For the times that we have not accepted God's love.
For the times that we have not shared his love with others, we ask him now for his forgiveness. Lord Jesus, you came among us to show us your Father's love. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you died on the cross that we might live with you forever. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you pray for us at the right hand of your Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord,
may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray first for a moment in the silence of our hearts. Loving God, these your children became your sons and daughters when they received the sacrament of baptism. Today, you nourish them for the first time with the gift of your Son, Jesus, the bread of life, the cup of eternal salvation. Guide and protect them always on their journey through life. May they stay close to you. This we ask through Christ our risen Lord. Amen.
A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. I received from the Lord what I handed on to you namely, that the Lord Jesus, on the night in which he was betrayed, took bread and after and gave thanks, broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." This
disciples of Jesus said to him, "Where do you want us to go and prepare for you to eat the Passover supper?" He sent two of his disciples, and he said to them, "Go into the city, and the man will meet you, carrying a jar of water. Follow him. Wherever he enters, say to the master of the house, 'The teacher says, where is my guest room, where I may eat the Passover with my disciples?' Then he will show you a large upper room furnished and ready. Make the preparations for us there." The disciples then went off, entered the city, and found it just as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover supper. While they were eating, he took bread, said the blessing, broke it, and gave it to them, saying, "Take it, this is my body." Then he took a cup, and he gave thanks, and he gave it to them, and they all drank from it. He said to them, "This is my blood of the covenant, which will be shed for many. Amen, I say to you, I shall not drink again the fruit of the vine until the day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God." Then after singing a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. The Gospel of the Lord. Boys and girls, I want to ask you a question. And I don't want you to answer this question right away. I want you to think about it before you answer it. All of us are here with you because for the first time, you're going to eat food and drink some drink that is very different than any other food or drink that you've ever had before. The question is, why is it different? I don't want you to answer that right now. Now I'm going to give you some easier questions to answer right away. When you first had pizza, did you ever eat pizza?
Yes.
Okay. When you first had pizza, okay, did your mom and dad call up everybody in the family and say, "Hey, Anthony's going to have pizza on Saturday. Isn't that great?" Did they do that? No. When you first drank soda, did your parents say to you, "Stephanie, Saturday you're going to have Coca-Cola for the first time, so we bought you a brand new dress so you can all dress up so when you drink this Coca-Cola"? Did they say that to you? When you first ate steak, and I'm sure you kids, you look like you're good steak eaters, okay? When you first ate steak, did your parents say, "Look, we're going to invite the entire family to St. Clare's on Saturday morning, and you're going to be all dressed up because we want to all watch you eat steak"? Did they do that? Well, all of us are here today because you're going to eat some food and drink some drink that is very different. So your entire family is here. Your teachers are here. Your priest is here. And you're all dressed up in the best clothes that you could possibly wear. Because for the very first time, you are going to eat this bread and drink this wine. But why is it different? Who can tell me? Why is it different? Because it's blessed. Very good. Can everybody add to that? Not only is it blessed, but it is Jesus' body and blood. At this table that you're invited to today, for the very first time, Jesus is going to come to you. The bread of life, the cup of our salvation, of our grace. I want you kids to take a look at your hands. Open your hands like this and take a look at them. In a little while, you're going to come up the aisle and I'm going to say to you the body of Christ. What's your answer to that? You see how well trained you are? Amen. And then you're going to accept Jesus in your hands, and you're going to gently place that sacred host in your mouth, and that is going to become part of you. Some of you may come up this aisle, and when I say the body of Christ and you answer amen, I may just simply place it in your mouth, if that's the way you prefer, on your tongue. And again, Jesus is going to become part of you. And some of you, after you receive the body of Christ, you're going to move to another minister. And they will say to you, the blood of Christ. And what's the answer to that? Amen. And you'll take that cup and you'll take a drink from it. And Jesus becomes part of you. Does anybody know why Jesus wants to become a part of you? Why he wants you to receive him in your hearts today? Oh boy, that's the best answer, and I know no one could hear you, but because you said it right to me, because he loves you. That is exactly right. That is why he's coming to you today, because he loves you. And does Jesus want anything in return from you? Does he want anything in return from you? He wants you to love him. That's right. That's why he becomes part of you today. Because he loves you, and he wants you to love him. And if you're going to love him, then you know what? You need